welcome to the final video on the series of videos on SQL queries on employee salary database. In today's video, we are going to see how to write a SQL query to find out the incremented salary for those employees who have completed 2 years with the organization. So this is going to be a fairly simple query. We are only going to make use of some date functions. So before we start, let me just give you a quick recap of what all we have covered in the previous videos. So we have covered scenarios like finding the employees with the maximum salary in the department, finding the employees with the average salary or greater than the average salary of the department, or greater than the average salary of the department but less than the overall average, also greater than the average salary or less than the average salary of the department and greater than the average salary of any other department. Then we also found out how to write a SQL query to find employees whose salary is greater than their manager's salary. And now today we are going to take a look at finding out the incremented salary based on some condition on the date of hiring for that employee. So if you want to check out any of these videos, then there are links provided in the description below and you can check out the other videos as well. So let's get started with the scenario for today. So we have been working with this employee table, and if we take a look over here, then we would see that there is a column called hire date, and based on this hire date we are going to calculate the number of years that the employee has been with the organization, and based on that we are going to provide some increment to the employee. So let's get started with writing the query. So this is going to be a fairly simple query, no subqueries or self joins. We are just going to fetch some information for the employee. So I'm just copying this select statement from one of our previous queries and pasting it here. Okay, so here it is. And now we are just going to make use of the where clause to first of all find out the employees who have completed 2 years with the organization. So to find out that year difference between a certain date, which for us is 31st December 2020, and the hire date of the employee, there is a date function called Datediff that we're going to use. Now we are going to use this function. And what this actually does is give us the difference in either years, months or days between two distinct dates. So for us, that interval that we want is going to be year. And then we want the difference between the hire date, then we can put the hire date and the current date. Not the current date exactly, we want the difference as of 2020, 12, 30. First as a difference. So instead of putting it in the where clause, let's first put it in the select clause to see what is the output from this particular function. So let's just execute this query, and you would see that there is certain calculation that it has done. To make more sense of that, let's select the hire date column as well, and now let's just execute this query. Alright, so you can see that for all these employees, so for this first employee, the year of hiring was 2006, and we are calculating in years the difference between 2020 and 2006, so that is going to be 14 years. For this employee who was hired in 2007, the difference is going to be 13 years, and so on. So this function works to identify the difference between two dates in the interval that you specify. So this is a function. Now let's remove this function and use it in our where clause. And a simple condition is that these employees have completed 2 years with the organization. So what we are saying is that it is greater than two. So greater than 2 years. You can also put greater than equal to if you want. So if I run this query now, it is going to give me all the 50 rows that I have in this sample data, because I mean all the years that I have in the sample data, either 2006 or 2007 or so on, so they are all going to be greater than 2. Let's change this value and make it, let's say, greater than 15, and it would filter out some of the records. Actually, it filtered out all the records. So okay, greater than 13, because we saw 14 was there. So you get certain records which have years of which have worked for greater than 13 years for this company. So this is basically how this function can help you find out all those employees who have completed a certain number of years with the company. Now, the other part of the requirement is to give them an incremented salary. So let's say they we have a fixed increment percentage of, let's say, 15%. So now we have to calculate the incremented salary. So that is simple. You can just do a salary and multiplication by 1.15, all right? And that would be that their incremented salary. And just execute this query. So this will help you calculate the incremented salary for all the employees who have completed a certain number of years with the organization. Now, further complication for this scenario could be that you have different scenarios based for different number of years that the employee has completed. So let's say for employees who have completed 2 years, you want to increment the salary by 15%. The employees who have completed 15 years, you want to increment the salary by 20% or so on. So in that case, let me just give you a hint. You can go ahead and use a case statement, all right? And you can frame your queries, and you might have to write a few subqueries, and you might have to first create a temporary table or a CDE where you identify all those employees based on their hire date and so on. So I would let you guys write that query. So if you want to share that query with us, then feel free to post it in the comments below. Otherwise, it's a simple hint. You can use the case statement and you would be able to frame that query. So this was the last query and one of the easiest queries in our series on all those SQL queries on employee salary database. I do hope that you like this series. If you did, then please do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And thank you a lot for watching this video. Goodbye and till we meet.